A very good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Abhay Deshpande, Associate Professor, RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. And today I'm doing some review problems from VTU question papers related to Unit 4 and 5. So that is the today's outline. Let us start with examples. Example number one, a point charge Q is equal to 18 nanocoulomb has a velocity of 5 into 10 to the power 6 meter per second in the direction A is equal to 0.6 AX plus 0.75 AY plus 0.3 AZ. Calculate the magnitude of the force exerted on the charge by the field B is equal to minus 3 AX plus 4 AY plus 6 AZ millitesla. So I need to calculate the magnitude of the force, that is F. So I need to use the Lorentz force equation, that is nothing but F is equal to Q into V cross B, where Q is the point charge, V is the velocity, 5 into 10 to the power 6 meter per second in the direction of A, and B is the magnetic field. So the Q value is 18 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulombs. B value they have given, minus 3 AX plus 4 AY plus 6 AZ milli, hence 10 to the power minus 3 tesla, and velocity magnitude is 5 into 10 to the power 6 meter per second, and direction is 0.6 AX plus 0.75 AY plus 0.3 AZ. So let us calculate V first. That is, V is nothing but the magnitude into direction. Magnitude is 5 into 10 to the power 6 and direction is A. So direction is A. This is the direction. Now let us substitute the value of V, Q as well as V in the equation of F. That is, F becomes Q into, Q value is 18 into 10 to the power minus 9 into V cross B. V value is this, that is 5 into 10 to the power 6, 0.6 AX plus 0.75 AY plus 0.3 AZ, and B value is minus 3 AX plus 4 AY plus 6 AZ into 10 to the power minus 3, because it is given in milli. Now let us multiply this along with this term, and let us find out the cross product of 0.6 AX plus 0.75 AY plus 0.3 AZ into minus 3 AX plus 4 AY plus 6 AZ. So constant I'll maintain as it is, then AX, AY, AZ, first row 0.6, 0.75, 0.3, second row minus 3 plus 4 plus 6. Constant as it is. Then AX into 6 into 0.75 minus 4 into 0.3, that is 4.5 minus 1.2, minus AY into 0.6 into 6 minus of minus plus 3 into 0.3, that is 3.6 plus 0.9. plus AZ into 0.6 into 4, that is 2.4, minus of minus plus 3 into 0.75, I'll get 2.25. So I will get F value is equal to, I'll multiply this 9 inside, I'll get 29.7 AX minus 40.5 AY plus 41.85 AZ into 10 to the power minus 5 newtons. So if I want to find the magnitude of the force, then under root of 29.7 whole square plus minus 40.5 whole square plus 41.85 whole square into 10 to the power minus 5 whole square. So let us find out, simplify this and calculate the value of magnitude of the force, that is F is equal to. So we'll get approximately the force value is 653.7 micronewtons. That is the force exerted on the charge by the field. So this is the force, that is 653.7 micronewtons. Let us take example 2, second example. A current carrying conductor 4 cm long is always along y axis with a current 10 milliamps flowing in y direction. Determine the force on the conductor due to a magnetic field H is equal to pi ax divided by mu ampere per meter. So there is a conductor which is carrying a current of 10 milliamp and of 4 cm long in length along y direction, and I need to calculate force on the conductor. So force on the conductor of length is given by F is equal to I into L cross B. Force on a conductor is given by F is equal to I into L cross B. I value is 10 milli and 10 into 10 to the power minus 3. The length is 4 cm along y direction, hence 4 into 10 to the power minus 2 ay along y direction. And B value, they have given as H value 5 ax by mu, hence B value is mu into H. And mu will get cancelled. I will get H is equal to 5 ax is the value of B, that is magnetic field. Now let us calculate F value, that is I into L cross B. I is 10 into 10 to the power minus 3. L is 4 into 10 to the power minus 2 in ay direction. And B value is 5 ax. So let us multiply all the terms, that is 10 into 4 into 5 and 10 to the power minus 3 into 10 to the power minus 2, and ay cross ax we will get it as minus az, and this after simplifying we will get it as the force F is equal to minus 2 az into 10 to the power minus 3 newton. The force on the conductor is F is equal to minus 2 az into 10 to the power minus 3 newton. Next example, let us take example number 3. That is, find the magnetization in a magnetic material where mu is equal to 1.8 into 10 to the power minus 5 and H is equal to 120 ampere per meter. First one. Second one, mu r is 22 and there are 8.3 into 10 to the power 28 atoms per meter cube, that is m cube, and each atom has a dipole moment of 4.5 into 10 to the power minus 7. Second case. And third case is B is equal to 300 micro tesla and the XM, that is susceptibility value is 15. So I need to calculate magnetization in magnetic materials. Magnetization is represented by capital M. So let us start solving this. Let us consider case 1, and from the data we have mu value is 1.8 into 10 to the power minus 5 and h is equal to 120 ampere per meter. And we know that the magnetization m is given by m is equal to mu r minus 1 into h. So mu r is nothing but mu divided by mu naught, because mu is equal to mu naught into mu r. Hence mu r is equal to mu divided by mu naught, we will write minus 1 into h as it is equal to mu value. So they have given mu value as 1.8 into 10 to the power minus 5 divided by mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 minus 1 into h value. They have given h value as 120. So from this we can calculate the value of magnetization, that is m is equal to, we will get answer as 1599. We will get magnetization m is equal to 1599. Now let us consider second case, that is from the data they have given mu r is equal to 22 and n, that is there are totally 8.3 into 10 to the power 28 atoms are there. Hence n value is 8.3 into 10 to the power 28. Then the small m value they have given m value as, the dipole moment they have given as 4.5 into 10 to the power minus 7. Hence the small m value dipole moment is 4.5 into 10 to the power minus 27. Now we know that again magnetization capital M is equal to N into M. That is in case of dipole moment we have seen this equation. Capital M is equal to small n into small m, and N value they have given 8.3 into 10 to the power 28 and M value they have given as 4.5 into 10 to the power minus 27. So if I multiply this again, I will get magnetization M is equal to 373.5. The magnetization M value is 373.5. Units we have to write, that is A bar M. Now similarly, let us do it for the third case. In third case, they have given data as B value is 300 into 10 to the power minus 6 Tesla and susceptibility is 15. 300 micro it is, hence 10 to the power minus 6 Tesla and susceptibility is 15. Now we know that B is equal to mu into H, that is mu naught into mu r into H, B value. And the susceptibility XM is given by M divided by H, or else H we can write it as M divided by susceptibility. So this value of H, if I substitute in magnetic flux, that is B is equal to mu naught mu r h, and in place of h I will write it as m divided by xm, that is susceptibility. So I'll write this as b is equal to mu naught into mu r into m divided by xm. But I need here the value of m, that is magnetization. Hence I will write this as b into xm divided by mu naught into mu r. We can write this equation as B into XM divided by mu naught into mu r, and M is equal to B into XM divided by mu naught into mu r value can be written as XM plus 1, because we know that XM is equal to mu r minus 1 we will write. So mu r is equal to XM plus 1, that is susceptibility plus 1. So I have written the equation here, M value. Now substitute the value of B. B is 3 into 10 to the power minus 6. susceptibility is 15 divided by mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 into xm value is 15 plus 1. So this is the value of magnetization. Simplify this and we will get it as almost approximately 224. The answer for M, we will get it as 224. So sometimes there will be some redundant data. That is, if you see in case 2, the value of mu r is redundant because this value of mu r we have not at all used to calculate the magnetization. So sometimes some data are redundant. So this is how we can calculate the value of magnetization in different cases. Now let us see the fourth example on boundary conditions. The z is equal to zero plane marks the boundary between two magnetic media. Medium 1 is the region z is greater than 0 and medium 2 is the region z is less than 0. Then the magnetic flux density in the medium 1 is B1 is equal to 1.5 AX plus 0.8 AY plus 0.6 AZ millitesla. So the question is to find the magnetic flux density at medium 2. So they have given the flux in medium 1 B1. And I need to calculate the value of B2, that is in medium 2. So the medium 1 is in free space, that is assume medium 1 as a free space and mu r for medium 2 as 100. So for second medium, the value of mu r is equal to 100. For first medium, since it is a free space, the mu r value is 1. Now let us write the value of B1, that is flux in B1. I need to calculate flux in B2. So before that, consider flux in B1 is equal to 1.5 AX plus 0.8 AY plus 0.6 AZ. Now from this, first find out the normal component, that is since the medium, that is the boundary is at z axis. So medium 1 is the region z is greater than 0 and 2 is the region z is less than 0. Hence we can write the normal component of B is az direction, that is 0.6 az is the normal component, millitesla is the normal component of B, and the remaining one is the tangential component, that is x and y component, that is 1.5 ax plus 0.8 ay is the tangential component and normal component is 0.6 az. From the given value of B1, we can find out the normal as well as tangential component in medium 1. Now I need to calculate the total flux in medium 2, that means both tangential as well as normal component. Hence, we know that the normal component across the boundary will remain same, that is BN1 is equal to BN2, but the BT2 I need to calculate based on the data of BT1 what I have calculated, that is tangential component in medium 2, we need to calculate BT2. So we know that H is equal to B by mu because B is equal to mu into H, hence HT1 is equal to BT1 by mu 1 and HT2 is equal to BT2 by mu 2. That is in medium 1 and medium 2, that is magnetic flux, tangential component. But we know that HT1 is equal to HT2, that is tangential component, electric field intensities are same. Hence, if HT1 should be is equal to HT2, that means BT1 by mu1 is equal to BT2 divided by mu2. So I need to calculate the value of BT2. That is BT2 is equal to 100 BT1. 100 because the value of mu r in medium 2 they have given as 100. Hence BT2 is equal to 100 into BT1 and mu1 value is 1 because medium 1 is free space. So I'll write BT2 is equal to 100 into BT1 and BT2 is equal to 100 into BT1. Substitute the value of BT1 as 1.5 AX plus 0.8 AY. Multiply this, then I will get 100 into 1.5. That is 150 AX plus 80 AY is the tangential component of magnetic flux density BT2 in medium 2. Now I need to calculate the value of flux density, total flux density in medium 2, that is B2 I want. Hence B2 is equal to BT2 plus BN2, that is tangential as well as normal component I need to add. Then the tangential component, just now I have calculated as 150 AX plus 80 AY plus the normal component is 0.6 ESA, because normal component in flux density will remain same. Hence the value of B, the magnetic flux density in medium 2, is given by 150 AX plus 80 AY plus 0.6 AZ millitesla. This is the value of B in medium 2. So let us see some formulas. In magnetic field, force on a moving charge, F equal to Q into V cross B. Force on a differential current element is I into DL cross B. Force on a straight current carrying conductor, F is equal to I into L cross B. Then torque on a rectangular current loop is T is equal to current I into A cross B. EMF, integral of V cross B in DL. Force between two parallel current carrying conductor is F is equal to mu into L IA into IB by 2 pi D. Magnetization, just now we have done the numerical. Susceptibility is equal to M by H. Hence field flux density B is equal to mu naught into H plus M, we will write. The magnetization M is given by H into mu r minus 1. And in band boundary conditions, the field intensity in tangential components are equal and flux density in normal components are equal. And in magnetic circuit, we have a reluctance S equal to L by mu A, and reluctance in series is L1 by mu 1 A plus L2 by mu 2 A. So after that, inductances, solenoidal coil, toroidal coil, coaxial cable, two wire line we have done. Solenoidal, L is equal to mu naught into N square by A, N square A by L. Toroid is L is equal to mu naught into N square A divided by 2 pi R. Coaxial cable is capital L by small l, that is mu naught by 2 pi into ln of R2 by R1. Two wire line, that is L by L is mu naught by pi into ln of D by A. Then energy stored in magnetic field is given by W equal to half Li square. Energy density in the magnetic field is given by W is equal to half mu H square. And the mutual inductance, that is EMF induced by the mutual inductance, is E2 is equal to minus M21 into Di1 by dt. So these are the few equations what we have learned in unit number 4. Now let us take the fifth example. that is given E is equal to Em sine of omega t minus beta z in Ay direction in free space. Calculate D, B and H. I need to calculate D, B and H. So the given equation is E is equal to Em into sine of omega t minus beta z. That is E value they have given, electric field intensity. Now I need to calculate D, the first one. To find out D, D is given by D is equal to epsilon naught times E. Epsilon naught as it is, E value is Em sine of omega t minus beta z in Ay direction. That is the value of D. Now then I need to calculate the value of B. Now the electric field intensity E and the magnetic flux density B can be related in Maxwell's equation as del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou T. That is the Faraday's law what we have done in time varying field, because the given field E is varying with respect to time omega T. Hence, we need to use the Maxwell's equation for time varying field, that is del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou T, and we need to substitute the value of E to find the value of B. So let us substitute the value of E and find the cross product. E is having only Y component, hence AX, AY, AZ, dou by dou X, dou by dou Y, dou by dou Z and 0, Em sine omega t minus beta z and 0. That is the E value. This E value I have substituted and last one is 0. Now let us find out the cross product. Let us find out the cross product. So AX as it is into dou by dou Y of 0 minus dou by dou Z of this term, that is Em sine omega t minus beta Z, minus AY into 0 because these two terms are 0, plus AZ into dou by dou X of this term, that is Em sine omega t minus beta Z, minus dou by dou Y of 0 is 0. Now if you see here, the dou by dou X of this term is 0 because there is no term containing X. Hence, this behave as a constant, derivative of constant becomes 0. Now, only left out term is this, that is minus dou by dou Z of Em sine omega t minus beta Z. Derivative of sine is minus cos, minus with minus plus. So, derivative of sine with respect to Z is minus beta we will get. Hence the answer is beta into Em constant as it is into cos of omega t minus beta Z in AX direction. So this is the value of del cross E. Now I need the value of B. Hence del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou T, and minus dou B by dou T is equal to del cross E I will write, and del cross E value I have calculated here, that is beta Em cos of omega T minus beta Z. I will substitute. Now I will integrate this, that is B is equal to, after integrating I will get minus beta Em into integration of cos is sine of omega t minus beta z into omega t integration. I will get divided by omega in AX direction. Hence the value of B I will get it as B is equal to minus beta times Em divided by omega sine of omega t minus beta z. That is the magnetic flux B. Now third one is very simple to find H. So we know B is equal to mu naught into H in free space. If I take, then H is equal to B by mu naught, and B value is this value, that is minus beta into Em sine of omega t minus beta z divided by omega. Now we need to divide by mu naught also, mu naught in AX direction. So this is the magnetic flux density H. So this is how we need to calculate the value of D, B as well as H. A similar kind of example, let us take one more example, number 6. That is, let mu is equal to 3 into 10 to the power minus 5, epsilon equal to 1.2 into 10 to the power minus 10, and sigma is equal to 0 everywhere. And they have given H is equal to 2 cos 10 to the power 10 t minus beta z beta x in the AZ component, ampere per meter. Now I need to use the Maxwell's equations to obtain the expression for B, D and E. I need to find B, D and E. Now they have given H. H is 2 cos of 10 to the power 10 t minus beta x is that, and mu value also they have given. Now first one I need to calculate B. Very simple, B is equal to mu into H, and mu value they have given as 3 into 10 to the power minus 5 into H value is 2 cos 10 to the power 10 t minus beta x in AZ direction. So let us multiply this 3 into 2, 6 into 10 to the power minus 5 cos of 10 to the power 10 t minus beta z x. AZ component Tesla is the value of B. Now I need to calculate D. So using Maxwell's equation, we know that del cross H is equal to J plus dou D by dou T in time varying field. So here I will take J is equal to 0. Hence del cross H, we can write it as dou D by dou T. So first find out del cross H, that is AX, AY, AZ as it is. Dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, and H is having only z component, that is 2 cos 10 to the power 10 t minus beta x. Substitute here and remaining two terms will be 0. Now let us find out the cross product AX as it is, dou by dou y of this minus dou by dou z of 0 is 0, minus ay into dou by dou x of this term minus dou by dou z of 0 is 0 plus az into 0, because these two terms are 0. Now if you see this, dou by dou y of this term will also become 0, because this term doesn't have any y component, so it behaves as a constant. So it is equal to 0 minus ay as it is into this term, that is dou by dou x of this term. So dou by dou x of this term, derivative of cos, along with the beta x, I will get the value of del cross H, which is nothing but the value of J. I will get the value of J. And now I know that D is equal to integration of J into dt. So J value I have calculated. that is 2 beta sine of 10 to the power 10 t minus beta x is the value of j what I have calculated. J value and d value I will get it as minus 2 into 10 to the power minus 10 beta cos of 10 to the power 10 t minus beta x is the value of d. Cos integration of sine I will get it as cos, and j value is plus 2 into beta sine of 10 to the power 10 t minus beta x. That is the value of j I will get. So this is the simplification I have done for dou by dou x. Along with minus we will get it as plus, and we will substitute. Now to find E, that is D is equal to epsilon times C, and E is equal to D divided by epsilon. Epsilon value they have given in the numerical as 1.2 into 10 to the power minus 10. So substitute it. That is E is equal to D by epsilon, and simplify this, and I'll get E is equal to minus 1.67 beta cos of 10 to the power 10 t minus beta x into Ay component volt per meter. So this is how we will calculate the numericals on the field intensities and flux densities in Maxwell's equation. Let us have some summary points. E is equal to minus d phi by dt. E is integration closed path E dot dl. Inline integration E dot dl is equal to minus dou b by dou t dot ds. And in differential form, del cross E is equal to minus dou b by dou t. So we know that conduction current density is displacement current density equal to j omega epsilon A by d V naught e to the power j omega t in Maxwell's equation. And we have tabulated the Maxwell's equation in previous sessions. Now let us take example number 7. That is, the electric field in free space is given as the field electric field E is equal to 800 cos 10 to the power 8t minus beta y Az volt per meter. Now find out beta, lambda and h at the point P 1, 1.5, 0.4 at t is equal to 8 nanosecond. So I need to find out beta, lambda and h. They have given the field intensity E. Now we have a standard formula for field intensity, that is E is equal to E into cos of omega t minus beta y. That is in Az direction, hence I have written beta y. Now if you compare these two equation, we can write the value of omega is equal to 10 to the power 8, and we know beta is equal to omega by v, and omega value is 10 to the power 8 in the given problem, and v is velocity of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8. So from this I will get the value of beta, that is beta is equal to 0.333 radian per meter. Radian per meter is the value of phase constant beta. Now let us calculate the wavelength lambda, which is nothing but 2 pi by beta. 2 pi by beta value is 0.333. I have substituted, and then I will get the value of lambda. Wavelength is equal to 18.85 meters is the wavelength lambda I will get. Then the third one, I need H. So H is equal to E divided by eta. That is impedance. Eta is equal to the electric field by magnetic field, E by H. So in this question, they have given E and we need to calculate H. That is Hx is equal to Ez divided by eta in Ax component. Now Ez is 800 cos 10 to the power 80 minus beta y divided by impedance eta is 377. So if I simplify this, I will get the value as Hx value as 2.12 cos 10 to the power 80 minus beta y Ay component. Ax component. I will get H value as 2.12 cos 10 to the power 80 minus beta y. But I need to calculate H at a point they have given as 1, 1.5 and 0.4. Now looking at this, we need the value of T, beta as well as Y. Now beta value we have calculated as 0.333, and to get a Y they have given the point Y as 1, 1.5, 0.4. From this Y point is 1.5 and T value they have given as 8 into 10 to the power minus 9. So let us substitute these two components in the field intensity. H is equal to, that is 2.12 cos of 10 to the power 8. T value is 8 into 10 to the power minus 9 minus beta is 0.333 into Y is 1.5 in Ax component. Let us simplify this, and cos of this into 2.12 will give me the value of H in ampere per meter. So I'll get field intensity, magnetic field intensity H is equal to 2.02 in Ax component ampere per meter. So let us take one more problem on pointing vector. That is, a short vertical transmitting antenna erected on the surface of a perfectly conducting earth produces effective field strength is equal to 10 sin theta volt per meter at a distance of 1 kilometer from the antenna. Now compute the pointing vector and the total power radiated. So they have given the value of E, that is 100 sin theta. Now in complex form we can write this as 100 into e to the power j theta. And we need to calculate H. They have given the value of E. H is equal to E by eta, where eta is the intrinsic impedance. And the value is 377 is the intrinsic impedance value. Hence E divided by eta, that is 100 divided by 377, that is e to the power j theta or I theta ampere per meter. Now from the value of H, I will calculate H conjugate, that is 100 by 377 as it is into e to the power minus j theta in Ay component. So now I got the value of E and H conjugate. Now I can find out pointing vector as PAV is equal to half into real part of E cross H. So half into real part of 100 e to the power j theta into 100 e to the power minus j theta by 377 in AZ direction, watt per meter square, average power. And if I simplify only the real part, that is 100 into 100 by 2 into 377, I will get it as 13.263 is the value of pointing vector. Now I need to calculate the total power radiated. Hence, first I will calculate the area. Now area is 4 pi r square, and r value, they have given r value, distance as 1 kilometer. So 1 kilometer means 10 to the power 3. So 4 pi r square is 4 pi 10 to the power 3 square. That means 4 pi into 10 to the power 6 we will get. That is the total area, and the total power radiated is equal to the power flow, that is 13.263, whatever I have calculated, into 4 pi into 10 to the power 6. So using this, I will get the total power radiated as 1.6667 into 10 to the power 8 watts. This is the total power, whatever I will get. So this is how we have done the numerical on unit 5, that is uniform plane wave, as well as Poynting theorem, Poynting vector. Now let us have some summary points. That is, velocity of propagation of EM waves, V is 1 divided by under root of mu into epsilon. Mu value is mu naught mu r, epsilon naught epsilon r. And in free space, this mu r and epsilon r value will become 1, 1. Hence, mu naught and epsilon naught will remain. And the value we will get it as 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, which is nothing but velocity of light. So we have one more equation, V is equal to omega by beta, or beta is equal to omega into under root of mu into epsilon, where beta is the phase constant. Now, using this, we have an equation for wavelength lambda equal to 2 pi by beta. And we know angular frequency omega is equal to 2 pi f. Impedance, intrinsic impedance is eta is equal to E by H. That is equal to under root of mu by epsilon. So, in free space, mu value, that is intrinsic impedance, we will get it as 377 ohms. Or else eta is equal to under root of j omega mu divided by sigma plus j omega epsilon. Now propagation of EM waves in conducting medium, that is for lossy dielectric, I have both attenuation constant as well as phase constant. Now attenuation constant is this term, minus 1 you have. And the change in phase constant is, here we have plus 1. Next, propagation of EM waves, that is the medium, good conductor, good dielectric and perfect dielectric. Values should be sigma by omega epsilon should be very much greater than 1 for good conductors, should be less than 1 for dielectric, and it should be 1 for perfect dielectric. So I have tabulated the values of alpha, beta, gamma and eta. That is attenuation constant, phase constant, propagation constant and intrinsic impedance for these three types of mediums. Then skin depth, that is depth of penetration delta, is equal to under root of 1 divided by pi f mu into sigma, where sigma is the conductivity of the medium. So these are the equations for Poynting vectors. Now that is Poynting vector p is equal to e cross h, that is power flow, or else average Poynting vector. If I want to calculate, then p average is equal to e cross h average is half into real part of E cross H conjugate, or else P average is equal to E max square divided by 2 into eta. So these are the equations in Poynting vectors. So these are the equations what we have seen in case of wave propagation in plane waves. Now these are some of the references. The books which I have referred to deliver all my sessions, I have listed. That is, first one is Engineering Electromagnetics by William Hare. Second is Sadiku, that is Principle of Electromagnetics. Third one is Field Theory by Bakshi. And fourth one is Field Theory by Basavaraju. So all these references you can go through, and I have taken the numericals and the theory concept from all these sirs. Thank you all. Thank you very much.